Good morning, everybody. I'm Dr. Kalpana Kannan. I'm the overall coordinator for the massive open online courses at IIT Bombay, as well as large-scale teacher training. So I welcome you all to this program. Before we start, I would like to wish everybody a very happy Navaratri. And on this happy occasion, we are very happy to launch the Train 10,000 Librarians program. This is, you all must be very familiar with our large scale teacher training, the T10KT program. So based on similar lines, today we are launching the Train 10,000 Librarians program. So I welcome all of you to this program. And I would like to tell you the program for today. So for another half an hour or so, till around 10:15 or 10:20, we will be having the program from IIT Bombay, and then we will switch the control to IGNU in Delhi, and we have delegates in IGNU Delhi who will be addressing you from 10:30 to around 11 o'clock. So, and after that, there will be a tea break, and after that, you each RC will have to conduct the workshop using the spoken tutorial methodology, and there will be two parallel sessions, one for the librarians and one for the system admin. I hope I am clear about this program, and then maybe towards the end we will connect again to address the participants, but that we will announce a little later. So now I welcome Dr. Manju Nayaka. He is the Chief Library Officer at IIT Bombay Central Library. He would like to share his thoughts on COHA. So I welcome Dr. Manju Nayaka.
Thank you, Madam. Good morning to all of you. I welcome you all once again for this today COHA workshop, which is conducted under NVLI, National Virtual Library of India, Ministry of Culture, Government of India, which is an important the project to collect, disseminate the India's intellectual and cultural output of the country, where India's the output is reside in library, museum, archive. The institution which are holding these collections, librarians, library professionals, have a major role to achieve this national interest. So under this project, we want to train the massive the librarian under digital era. Library automation started in India around 4 decades ago, around 1980. Today we are in 2018, but still we have not automated the libraries. The challenges were many. One was cost of the hardware was too high, availability of the software were very few, and those were proprietary, not available so easily, and also cost was too high. And another third major challenge was availability of experts. Only few experts were available. So that is why in many libraries they could not automate their library using the latest the standards and technology available. Under this project, so we want to overcome all these challenges. The one is how to address this hardware cost was today. We need not to buy the hardware, particularly some of this hardware is provided by NVLI through virtual machine. Software is available in a open source like COHA, which is a proven, the stable and scalable the software. The expert is available in the form of spoken tutorial. So knowledge is already recorded. We need not to reinvest again and again to create the same tutorial. So once is created, used by thousands of time across the world. At IIT Bombay, within 6 months, we have automated a library by using a COHA. So imagine that traffic, the transaction, the number of staff logins required is too high, such a national institute of importance like IIT Bombay Central Library. So many institutions in India, like a small, whether private or public or academic library. So if you are using successfully, probably you also can implement a COHA in your organization very easily in a very the short period, which is an important to crawling the data for a national interest, for the national project like a NVLI. Koha started around 2000 in New Zealand by Kotipo Communication. The meaning of Koha means the gift. So this is a gift for the society, it's a gift for the community. So here, once you are using in whatever form, whether you are contributing a code, whether you are using a Koha, whether you are giving a suggestion, you are giving a gift back to the society. So indirectly, you are the owner of this, the software, you are the contributor. So Koha has the large community for participation as well as usage across the world. As I said earlier, you need not to worry about the any failure of the library automation. So all these the challenges taken care by the experts. So 100% definitely you can automate your library. You can make your institution collection not only to your user, to the global community. You can disseminate the India's intellectual and cultural output. Koha supports almost all international standards which we are using library community in day-to-day practice, like Mark 21, the UniMark, OAAPMH, RFID, FRBR. Like that, there are several standards it taken care. So only we need to concentrate on our day-to-day activity, like a cataloging, like a issue or charging or discharging or renewal, suggestion, the procurement, all those things. Even interlibrary loan is also international procedure has been followed here. Almost all the housekeeping activities of the library, such as acquisition, the circulation, serial control, web OPAC, and also record reporting, in several, almost all the function it supports, irrespective of the library, whether your library is a public library, whether college library, whether university library, whether special library. It is a scalable library software. It will meets the almost all the requirements of the library. Since it is being all over the world, so popularity is increased. Every 6 months, the new version is coming up. So currently, 18.05 version Koha is available. So you can, okay, without any hesitation, you can use this Koha to implement your library. And also, this methodology which is used is a very standard proven methodology, spoken tutorial, blended, MOOC, the learning. I hope you will learn whatever technical things are required to automate it in your library in a very short period. Please concentration on this. The tutorial, we have meticulously followed whatever steps are required for our day-to-day library activities, from membership to library housekeeping activity, from issue or return and cataloging, and also as well as to searching of the records by end user. With this few words about Koha library automation software as well as spoken tutorial methodology, I hope you will learn many things about the Koha features. This learning outcome will be much more better than any other learning. With these few words, I will conclude my speech. I wish you all the best. Thank you very much. Thank you, madam.
Thank you, Dr. Manjunayaka. That was a very good introduction to the workshop today. Now I welcome Professor Supratik Chakravarti. He is a professor in the Department of Computer Science at IIT Bombay, and he is also the project investigator for our project ESOS. ESOS stands for Education Services for Outreach at Scale. So I welcome Professor Chakravarti.
Yeah, hello, good morning everybody. It's a pleasure to have all of you with us today. So as you know, today's workshop is about an open source software for library. It's a comprehensive library management and administration. So we are very glad that there are over 2,000 participants who are participating today, including librarians and system administrators. So we hope you will have a very fruitful session today, and it will be a hands-on session, so you will actually see this software working live in your remote centers, whichever remote center you have come to. And at the end of the day, there will again be a live session.
Yeah.
From 5 to 6, where we will again consolidate and answer any questions. So, without much ado, I will hand it over to Kalpana, and all the best for today's workshop. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Chakravarti.
So, we are switching over to IGNU now.
Welcome you all to this train 10,000 librarian workshop. This is the first time such a large workshop is being attempted for the librarians. This is being done by the NVLI project, National Virtual Library of India, funded by the Ministry of Culture. I welcome all the participants in all the 100 remote centers for having come early in the morning and being around. We will shortly start the formal inaugural at 10:30. In the meantime, I thought that we can have some interaction. If there are any questions from any of the remote centers, they can hand raise and we will connect you, and you can ask the questions for everybody else to see. Are there any questions from any remote centers? If so, please go ahead and connect them. Good morning. So can you tell, for the benefit of listeners, participants in other centers, in which district, which state of India you are in, and then how many participants are there, how many librarians are there, just to get a feel for it. Thank you.
So we are from Ganganga Institute of Technology and Sciences, Jabalpur, sir.
Okay.
And we have 8 participants with us registered.
Okay, do you have any questions on how to conduct this workshop?
Yeah, there is no such, questions from our side.
Okay,
like,
then.
One of our participants has asked that, is there any backup for the software is required, and how to get the backups for the cataloging all this?
Yeah. So we will address them towards the end of the day. We'll get started with learning koha. Today we are going to do 2 types of workshops. One is for the librarians, how to use koha. The other one is for the system administrators, who will learn how to install koha. Towards the end of the day, we'll ask specific questions. So thanks for joining. Now we will see if we can connect to some other remote center.
Good morning, sir. This is Shubhrendu Govanyogi from 1132. We have 4 participants today. And I, being a remote center coordinator, and with my team coordinating this workshop. So the question, I'm just giving it to participant, but before that I would like to ask, see, today we are conducting this workshop, and later on when they will go back and install this software, so they also require our help, also your help, to run this koha smoothly in their centers. So I am having one more participant with me who is having some questions regarding koha, so I am giving mic to him.
Sir, so before that, can you please tell what state you are in, what district, so that the other participants in the other 100 remote centers know?
Professor Shubhrendu Govanyogi, head of IT from remote center 1132, Sir Padampat Singhani University, Udaipur, Rajasthan. So these participants are from little far, means they are from 100 kilometers around. So We tried our level best to connect local libraries also, but finally we managed to get 4 participants from nearby centers.
No problem. So, thanks. Yeah. Ask the participants.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, good morning, sir. Sir, I am from RS Kumar from Mewar University, that is in Rajasthan. And just we have joined to this workshop for installation and all the process on that Koha. And we are going to run to this software in our university. So just I have joined to this workshop, and right now they are helping to us that how we can installation virtual image and O12 and other Linux software, and after that installation of the Koha. So sir, just I have heard a lot of about that Koha, and right now we are going to installation in our university, that Koha. So just we are learning for here, and right now I haven't any problem in this process. And again, if I have any problem, then I'll call, sir.
Yeah, thanks. We are ready to help. In fact, we have set up forums. You will learn the usage of Koha through a method called Spoken Tutorials. And we have a forum on our webpage. In that, you can ask questions based on the tutorial in which you have the question, at what time you have the question, what minute, what second, and so on. For example, you can say, I have a question in the 3rd tutorial. Okay, it will have a name, of course. The name will appear, pull down menu, you open it, and then you say that I have a question between 3 and 4 minutes. Then once you have selected, you can say that I have a question between 20 and 30 seconds. Then the question page will appear, you can ask your question, and somebody will answer. And that question and answer, that discussion, will be available to everybody else who uses Koha. So this is a method that we have created to make the question and answer also useful as learning material. It's an organized FAQ, if you wish. So we would do that, and we will also add more tutorials. One of the things we plan to do towards the end of the day is to expose you to tutorials that teach you how to ingest CSV files. That is, suppose you have your data already in Excel, for example. For some people, it may be easier to generate that data using Excel. Some of you may already have it. It may also be possible that you have some other database from that you export as a CSV file. So whatever it is, you might have a CSV file. Then how to convert that CSV into Mark 21? That is one tutorial. Then once you have Mark 21, how to read that into Koha so that you don't have to type the data once again. So this is something that we are going to let you do. We already have tutorials. The only thing is, we have created them for Windows because most of you are likely to be using Windows machine. So we are starting from CSV. So the method is the same. If you have Linux, it's going to be a lot easier. But we are taking the stand that most of you are likely to be using Windows, and we have created tutorials for that. So if you have access to a Windows machine, I would want you to practice them at 4 o'clock, I think, if I'm not mistaken, after the tea break in the afternoon, you will do that. So starting from the data, how to take this into Koha, how to maintain it, how to create circulation, how to add patrons, do lending, and so on. Because Koha is an amazing library management software, open source.
Definitely.
Okay. So, further help will be available, provided, and then once again, we will meet in the afternoon in the discussion session. In the meantime, we can go to some other remote center. Thank you.
Thank you. Good morning, sir. My name is Professor Amar Mudiraj. I am from RCID 1098, Marathwada Institute of Technology, from Aurangabad, Maharashtra. We are very fortunate that we have 34 participants get registered to this workshop from our remote center. And out of that 34, 30 participants are attending the morning session. And I have a couple of questions. The very first question is that regarding the backup issues of Koha. And another issue was the installation of Koha, but we and our team of system administrator, teaching assistant and my students have been work from last 2 days, and we are ready with the enough number of computers for the participants to learn the Koha effectively.
Yes, so Marathwada Institute is in Aurangabad. If you people can create Ajanta, Ellora, 2000 years ago, Koha is nothing, piece of cake. So you'll be able to do a fantastic job. The way the workshop is arranged, it is a self-paced workshop. Some people will learn all the tutorials in one go. You might already know, you'll find it very easy. Whereas some other people will say that, look, I'm learning it first time. I cannot learn all of that today. That's fine. Even you will end up learning 7-8 tutorials, if not all 15-16. But given time, you spend one more day at your leisure, copy all the tutorials on your pen drive, take them with you, learn whenever you have time, and within a day, you will reach the same level as everybody else. So this method is created for beginners and take them all the way to the highest level. I say that anybody can climb Himalayas if enough number of small steps are given. Sufficient number of small steps are given, anybody can climb Himalayas. So Koha is not rocket science. You can certainly learn. Okay, thank you. Is there any other remote center?
We are from Geetanjali Institute of Science and Technology, Nellur, Andhra Pradesh, remote center ID 1294. I'm remote center coordinator. Today we have 40 participants gathered here. They have a few queries. I'll hand over mic to them.
Good morning, sir. Sir, how to set up a regional language in Koha data entry?
Okay, first of all, I want to congratulate you for attending this workshop in spite of Titli. I know that it has subsided now. It's not it's not life-threatening anymore. But nevertheless, that there were 3-meter high waves, I believe. So I want to thank you all for coming to the workshop. We will take this up. You asked an important question, how to accommodate that. I don't think we have any spoken tutorial yet. We will add more tutorials and we will make them available. Thank you.
I have 2 questions. One question is there any OPAC facility in the Koha? And second question is, title wise means how in one particular subject, if I need title wise data, do I get in this Koha?
So the answer to the first question is yes, we have. Maybe some of these questions can be answered after you go through the content. So we will meet again at in the afternoon, between 5 and 6, we will answer your questions. Then we can also have librarians to answer your questions. I'm not a librarian. We are just putting together this workshop. Answer to second question is, Koha is a library management software. So whatever you put can be retrieved, made available. And it is also possible to automate some of these activities. So I'm going to stop here. I don't want to get too much into details. Those will be anyway discussed by the librarians. So thanks, Nellur, we will go to another remote center.
Sir, this is the GRIET. That is, regional center code is 1080 from Hyderabad, Telangana state. Sir, this is a heartily welcome, sir. We are conducting this program. This is the totally to awareness of that program, the COHA, entirely the participations of the librarians. This is the very appreciation of that program. The IITB is initiative to take the program. Very congratulations, sir. This is the tutorials is the very useful to us. That practical point of view, it is the very, very useful. You can conduct the regional wise by the Telangana or Andhra Pradesh or any one of the state in the practice of the 2 days program. In the to tie up the colleges or universities, JNTU Hyderabad, such tie up of that universities, they are the providing the lot of facilities. The practice point of view, that is the useful to the all the librarians. That is my suggestion, sir, from our study, from the Telangana.
Okay, thank you very much. We also plan to dub the tutorials into all 22 languages of our country, so it can be made available to everybody, including the librarians in small towns and villages. KOHA is an amazing software. It is being used throughout the world. So if a library science student, for example, learns KOHA, then he or she can get internship opportunity from anywhere. They can go to Smithsonian. They can go to the public library in Seattle, for example, which has an amazing library. There are amazing libraries throughout the world, both in developed and in countries like ours. It opens opportunities for all learners. It will be a great thing for library science students. So if you have any question, please ask specific question. Otherwise, we'll go to some other remote center. Thank you.
I'm from remote center, Chaibasa Engineering College, remote center code 1355. Sir, our institute from Jharkhand.
Okay. Welcome. Please go ahead. Ask your question.
Okay, sir.
Sir, any option in KOHA for taking the database?
Yes, it is possible to import data from some other database, and also it is possible to export data from KOHA. Both are possible. You will learn some of it today. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, let's go to another state.
We are from Kerala, St. Joseph Engineering and Technology, Palai. We have got 54 participants here.
Congratulations. And thank you for joining us in spite of all the problems you have had. And I want to also thank the St. Joseph's College administration for making your engineering college available in this noble cause of training the librarians. Thank you. Please go ahead with your question.
Sir, can we help in making a regional language version for the spoken tutorials?
We will have Malayalam dubbing, and any help will be welcome. We have our own person at IIT Bombay, and we'll be happy to work with you. Yes, definitely. We want to dub it into all 22 languages. All our languages are equal. We want to make them available in every language, irrespective of the number of people. For example, Sanskrit is one of our 22 languages. We'll make it available in Sanskrit also. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah, let's go to another state.
We are from MAM College of Engineering and Technology, which is in Trichy, and we have around 37 librarians here who have come from Perambalur, from surrounding districts. We are in Tamil Nadu, and I'd like to give it to a school librarian who has come, and she would like to ask a question.
I'm from a school librarian. So I want to know whether which was criteria was used by KOHA, it was useful for the school side. You have initiated any work for the school side. Now the coordinator said to me it is related to the public sectors and then college related. But I want to know it should be related to the, I mean, it should be useful for the school side also. So I'm the only person came from the school side. So, and private school also. So tell me that it is useful for that school sites also, and you have to initiate some works to school side also, support schools also, sir. That was a good library for us also.
Absolutely, absolutely. I'm really delighted to have a librarian from a school. Koha is definitely useful for school libraries also. It is useful for any library, any library. Doesn't matter whether it is in school, college, Tamil Nadu, Andhra, Assam, and then university, whether it is in India, Japan, San Francisco, and so on, right? So we are making it available to everybody. I also want help from you. Please spread the message amongst all schools. You might have a school library association. You tell this important thing. I would like to hear from you end of the day, whether you could follow it, whether it is useful to you. I'm pretty sure you will. I'll get a positive reply from you. And I want a help from you to share this news with all the fellow librarians from schools.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Sure, I'll connect you.
Okay, let's go to another state.
I'm from remote center 1058, Goa College of Engineering, Goa. We have 15 participants for this workshop. It is nice to collaborate with IIT Bombay for this workshop. And only one question I have is from the participants, and one more participant wants to talk to you also. That whether there will be a technical support from IIT to the libraries who are going to adopt this Koha software.
Welcome all of you. You must have started very early to reach the center at 9:30 in the morning. Through the NVLI project, that is National Virtual Library of India project, we plan to support this activity. So one of the questions already asked was, will there be a backup facility? We will create a spoken tutorial on how to do backup, and through the discussion forum, answer questions. Through spoken tutorials, help you migrate from one library to one library software to another software, help you migrate to new versions. So all kinds of things, everything is going to be considered. So the NVLI project funded by the Ministry of Culture will definitely be undertaking this. With, of course, a special focus on public libraries, because public libraries until now haven't had this kind of organized activity. So we would like to make it available to them. And the moment we make it available to them, it is going to be easily accessible to college libraries also. As I answered the question from a librarian from a school just a while ago, this will be available to school libraries also. So we are talking about creating a system that has the potential to catalog all the libraries throughout the country and make them available to everybody. And so it's an ambitious project. It cannot be done without your cooperation. We want all of you to join us. IIT Bombay is, of course, behind this. We also have in the NVLI project, IGNU as a member. In the formal program, you will get to see Professor Uma Kanjilal, the library sciences expert. We also have CDAC as a partner of this NVLI project. So we are here to support you. Thank you. All right, now we will get on with the formal program. Happy that we could receive questions from at least 10 states. Really delighted. We will get on with the formal program. Thank you.